students, today we'll discuss about principle of reversibility of light. So let us start that. Friends, let's start with the principle of reversibility of light. The statement is, if a ray of light undergoes a number of reflections and refractions, maybe reflections, maybe refraction, maybe both, and if following certain path, and if the direction of light is reversed, then it follows the same path it has traveled earlier. What is the meaning of this? Suppose I have a medium air here and another medium, say water here. Now light falls on this. In the interface of air and water, now it bends toward normal because water being a denser medium, it follows this path. Suppose I keep a mirror over here perpendicular to this so that the refracted ray incidence normally to the mirror, then we know that from the principle of reflections that any ray incidenting normal will return back to the same medium in the same direction. Only it will change the direction, it will get reversed. The direction is reversed. Now, therefore, it will move in this direction. After reflections, it will move in this direction. And it says that if the direction of light is reversed, you can see that if the direction of ray of light after refraction is reversed or reflection is reversed, then from here it is reversed. And then it will follow the same path and emerge from this line only. It is not going to come out from any other directions. Only this path. So this path is called, this principle is called principle of reversibility, or that means the ray of light reverses its direction and follows the same path that it used to followed earlier. So if I say that it goes from air to water following this path, then it has to come follow the same path if it is sent from this medium and from this point in this direction. Since the ray is reflected back in this direction, then it will follow the same path, retraces the same path. This is called principle of reversibility of light. From this we can conclude that mu of air here, or mu of water here, this is mu air, this is mu water. Then from here we say that if I apply Snell's law, then I'll write mu of water with respect to air is sin I upon sin r, where I is the angle of incidence and r is the angle of refraction. If the ray follows the reversible path, so for this case, this is I and this is R. So this is the equation I'm going to use. If this is air and water, it follows the same path. That means if I send it back in the opposite direction from here, then this is going to follow this path. This again, this retraces this path. So for this, if I write the equation for mu of air with respect to water, this will be sine of R by sine of I. So if you multiply these two together, then I get mu wa into mu aw equals to 1. Okay, this is known as principle of reversibility.